Hello, and thank you for choosing Translation Exchange as your localization partner. In this video, I will show you how to integrate Shopify application with Translation Exchange and get your store localized in any language. Here I have a basic Shopify application that I just created. In order to proceed with integration, we need to have a project created on Translation Exchange platform. I've done that already, and for more information on how to complete this step, please check our great videos and documentation in our documentation center, and links are provided below the video. Here's the Translation Exchange dashboard and created account named Test Shopify. This project is empty. There are no strings or sources because I did not integrate into our Shopify application. When you go to Integration API Key section, you can see our key and token information. Under Settings sections, we can see all the languages that are selected for this project. So let's get back to our Shopify site. Click on Online Store, select Themes, and to integrate Translation Exchange, we need to copy a simple code snippet into head section of Shopify application. So we'll select Edit HTML and CSS section, and we'll be taken to a list of files available for edit in Shopify. Our main file that we need to concentrate on is Theme Liquid, which is a main file for our theme that I'm using. Let's open it, and under head section on the top, we'll add our code snippet, and we'll add the comment that this is Translation Exchange code. Important note to have is to replace the key and the token with the information we got from Translation Exchange dashboard. So that almost completes our integration. Last step would be able to add language selector and let our users know that our site is available in multiple languages. So we offer a few simple language selectors part of our integration. It's a simple one line of HTML code, which you can place in any section of that fits your site design. In our example, I like to place a language selector on top right corner next to the cart. But you can select the header information, the footer information. You can create your own section. It all depends on how your site will look and feel. So the HTML code goes into the header file. So for that, we'll select the header file, and we'll type one line of code, which will represent a simple language selector. We have different options. You can read more on our language selector documentation in our site, and links are provided below. So now we have language selector integrated in our site. To complete integration, we need to enable translation mode, or we call it inline mode, so our SDK can extract all the strings and let us perform translations. You have two ways to enable it: using our keyboard shortcuts, which is simple Control Shift I. I means for the inline mode, or using a link on a language selector. Link is help us translate. That will turn translation mode on, and we can see that strings got different color underscores. So orange means that strings are recognized and getting extracted into our system. Once you refresh the page, some strings might be translated from previous translations that I've performed on a test site, and some will have a red underscore, which means they don't have a translation on the site and they need to be translated. So that completes integration, and you can see that your strings were extracted on a dashboard. You can see that sources are available as well. So to learn more on how to proceed with translations, how to order translations and perform releases, please check more videos and documentation on our site. You can check links below our video. And thank you for watching.